Hello, brothers and sisters. This is Kevin Cosby, St. Stephen Baptist Church, Louisville, Kentucky, with another powerful point to ponder as we spend meaningful moments with the Master on a daily basis. Thank you for joining me as we continue this thought, this theme. Get it in your spirit. God uses problems not to defeat us, but to develop us. That the adversity is for your advancement. In fact, the problem, strangely enough, is a gift. You may not see it while you're in it, but once you get through it and beyond it and look back over it in retrospect, you will say, my God, it was a gift to get me where God wanted me to be. Because God wanted the church to be at a certain place and they got stuck. God, that's a problem. Happen in order to unstuck them, to move them where they want to be. And sometimes it takes a problem, by the way, to light a fire under us. Is God using a problem to light a fire under you? Yesterday, we talked about the early church that was growing in Jerusalem, which is good, but God wanted them to grow beyond Jerusalem. There was diversity in this church, but there was also conflict, because with diversity comes conflict. The Greek-speaking widows were being neglected in the daily distribution of the food. And verse 1 says, Acts chapter 6, verse 1 says, in those days, enough of the disciples was increasing. The Hellenistic Jews, those are the Greek-speaking Jews, among them complained against the Hebraic Jews. So there is racial strife and tension between Greeks and Hebrews because of the distribution. In other words, the Greek-speaking women were saying there needs to be a redistribution, which is the number one issue in America today. Jeff Bezos has, listen to me, Jeff Bezos has, with Amazon.com, Jeff Bezos has $211 billion in wealth. Now, I want you to think about something. This one man has more wealth than all of Black America in terms of wealth. To combined. One man having more wealth than all Black America, Adolf's American descendants of slavery, combined. That's not fair. And so they're complaining about the distribution. And we should complain about economic injustice. And they complained to the apostles. These are the ones who were with Jesus. Now, whenever there is a problem, don't forget that the problem is designed to develop you, not to defeat you. And here's a problem. The apostles are being criticized for their leadership. And they didn't, the Greek women was being critical. And expect when you're in leadership, in fact, just expect in life for somebody to criticize you. If you're afraid of criticizing, then you will die doing nothing. Because anytime you're doing something, expect critics. Now, they've got a problem because these Greek-speaking women are being omitted. And they were being omitted. They were being excluded. It's what's called homogeneity. The Hebrew leadership was taking care of the Hebrew widows. And the Greek women could sense the bias. There is bias taking place. Now, when there is a problem, notice they complained. But the reason we don't bring resolution to many of our problems is because, one, here, listen to me, put it down, we ignore it. You want to fix a problem, you got to face a problem. So number one, don't ignore your problem. Don't ignore it. Amen. I once heard a story about a fraternity that stole the school mascot, which was a goat, and they were hiding it at the fraternity house. And someone asked the question, well, how will they deal with the smell? And someone responded, well, the goat will get used to it. In other words, it was not the goat that was smelling, it was the fraternity boys that was smelling. So in other words, the goat will get used to it. And many times we get used to things that we should not be getting used to. We accommodate ourselves to that which God never intended for us to accommodate ourselves to. So don't ignore the problem. Two, don't be defensive. Now, what could the disciples have said, the apostles? They could have looked at those Greek-speaking women and said, look, girl, We know how to distribute food. Don't forget, we were with Jesus when he took a last lunch of two fish and five loaves of bread. And we're the ones that dispersed the fish and the loaves to over 5,000 people. We know what we're doing. They could have become defensive. But the sign of your maturity is when someone can be critical of you and you don't jump to the defense. You say, is there any credibility or legitimacy in the complaint, the criticism? And there was. And that's why they're going to fix it. Three, when you're being criticized, don't overreact. Don't overreact. And they could have overreacted. Many times we overreact to criticism, to problems. If you see a roach, there's a way to get rid of a roach in your house, but don't blow up your house. Now, blowing up the house may kill the roach, but that's an overreaction. And many times we overreact. We become so overly emotional. And they didn't overreact to the problem. This is what they finally did, because they didn't ignore the problem. They were not defensive. They did not overreact. This is what they finally did. They found new procedures. They found new procedures. Go back to the text again. Let's close this out. Notice what it says. Acts chapter 6, verse 1 says, in those days when the number of the disciples was increasing, the Hellenistic Jews among them complained against the Hebraic Jews because the widows were being overlooked in the daily distribution of food. Verse 2. So the 12 gathered all the disciples together, the whole church, and said, it would not be right for us to neglect. So in other words, they're saying these Greek widows are legitimate. It would not be right for us to neglect the ministry of the word of God in order to wait tables, to feed. So the apostles were overwhelmed. That's the reason why the Greeks were being omitted. Brothers and sisters, choose 7 men from among you, who are known to be full of the Spirit. Now, this is the calling of the first deacons. And you look at Romans chapter 16, verses 1 and 2. We don't have that for you, but you read it in your leisure, because there's a woman deacon by the name of Phoebe. And I say that because there's a whole lot of chauvinists who say that women can't be deacons. But we read in Romans chapter 16, verses 1 and 2, that Phoebe was a deacon. So it says, brothers and sisters, this is being descriptive, not necessarily prescriptive. It's not prescribing that only men can be deacons or only men can be in leadership. Brothers and sisters, choose 7 men from among you who are known to be full of the Spirit and wisdom. We will turn this responsibility of feeding the widows, feeding the widows. And we'll give our attention to prayer and the ministry of the word. Stop here. So you've got two things going on here. The apostles' business and the deacons' business. And this is what this is the new procedure, because the new procedure is the apostles' business will be the word. We'll focus on the word. The deacons' business will be the widows, the widows. And go back to verse 4 again. And it says this in verse 4. At chapter 6, verse 4, and we'll give our attention to prayer and the ministry of the word. Let the deacons deal with the widows, and we'll deal with the word. And verse 5 says this. Verse 5 says, the proposal pleased the whole group. They chose Stephen. I'm the pastor of St. Stephen Baptist Church. They chose Stephen, a man full of faith and the Holy Ghost. And Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, Nicholas from Antioch. Stop here, a convert to Judaism. What I want you to notice is these are Greek men. So they got Greek men to deal with the Greek widows. It's homogeneity, Greek men. One of the reasons why our kids are not doing well in public schools is because there are not many black teachers. We've gotten rid of all the black teachers. And many of these black teachers have been miseducated and trained sometimes in schools that has desensitized them to black particular issues. They got Greeks to deal with Greeks. So they chose Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, Nicholas, Antioch, from Antioch, a convert to Judaism. And verse 6 says this. Verse 6 says, they presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. Verse 7 says, so the word of God spread. the number of disciples in Jerusalem increase. Here's the problem, though. It's increasing in Jerusalem, but it's not expanding to the uttermost parts of the world. It's all about Jerusalem. It's not about you. Listen to me. It's not about my church or your church. It's about us having an impact on the entire world. But it was good that they addressed the problem and came up with new procedures, because here is what happened as a result of it. The preaching grew better. The word of God said, spread. Verse 7 says, the word of God spread. So the preaching grew better. Attitudes grew brighter. The Greek women were not complaining. If you want to stop protests, then make sure there's equity in the distribution of opportunities. The attitudes grew brighter. The church grew bigger. The church started growing, and the witness of the church grew bolder as a result of a problem. And it all started with a problem. If there was not a problem, you would not have had the preaching better, the attitudes brighter, the church bigger, the witness bolder, because God uses problems to get us to where God wants us to be. God bless you. Let's pray together. Our God, we thank you for your word today. Bless your people. We'll be criticized sometimes, but don't let us overreact and become emotional. Help us to see the merit sometimes in the criticism and work towards new procedures. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I want to thank you for being with me for another powerful point to ponder. Look, if you don't have a church home, I'd like to extend an invitation to you to become a part of the St. Stephen Church family. Email us and we will get back with you. New start at ssclive.org. Also, I want to remind you that you can purchase a copy of my new book on my webpage. The title of the book is Getting to the Promised Land. And you can get your copy along with some other books that I've written. www.kevinwcosby.com. Thank you for being with me again today for another powerful point to ponder. And we'll pick up on this again tomorrow. But until then, don't forget during COVID-19 to stay safe and stay sane. And remember, God is still in control. God bless you. See you tomorrow.